white rim road.
This is the one where there's actual like
risk.
Risk involved.
There's serious
dying.
There's serious risk.
Well, not
here.
Just that, but like risky, you know, there's stuff. In this whole area, like we're talking like a 40-mile radius. There's no food, water, gasoline, anything. Like there's nothing.
Oh my God, we have no gas. I'm just kidding.
There's nothing.
Good thing we have an empty tank.
So. Here we go.
Someone once said that death is not the biggest fear we have. Our biggest fear is taking the risk to be alive. The risk to be alive and express what we really are. But what are we really? Life is full of uncertainties. We never know what's going to happen next. We'll have some good days, we'll have some bad. There are things that are outside of our control. One thing we do have is the ability to make choices, to take chances, to at least try and define our own path. So we ask ourselves a question. Who do we want to be?
Alright, so it's day one. Yesterday, got off the boat and met up with Eric and Greg, and we got all the gear together. We get all sorts of fun little cute obstacles to figure out.
Yeah, we can't use the AC, but I couldn't accelerate past 50 without the engine starting to go rough.
We had to be up at 7 to go get some tires swapped out on the car, and as soon as we're done with that, we're gonna hit the road. But I'm just excited, and today is Diablo Lake, and then we head to our campsite, which I hope we can find.
This is day one. Let the adventure commence. I don't have a beard, as you can tell. Well, I kind of do, but I'm growing it out for 3 weeks. We packed the car last night. I don't know how we're going to fit everything. We have a lot of food, a lot of camera equipment, and a lot of bags. And four of us in a 84 Subaru. And I just hope we get through one state. Do you think that's going to happen? I don't know.
Alright. Boom!
Aww.
Take three, everybody.
Yeah!
Driving cross country. We're going from Seattle to New York on basically spending less per person per week than the average American spends on food. And the whole idea is like doing this like really grand, huge adventure.
So to recap, our plan is to do this whole trip, 6,000 miles, gas, food, equipment, and everything else, all for less than the average American spends on food alone. We're doing it all with no GPS, no internet, and no clue what we're doing.
Oh, I just went the wrong way.
Really?
Yep, I was talking about maps. I'm gonna turn around.
We're fucking 1 mile in, we're lost.
You're welcome, guys.
Where we're camping doesn't directly have water, but there's a water, there's like a river a mile south of where we're camping.
Great. River? We gotta drink river water?
We have purifiers. We have purifiers.
That's the, yeah.
Yeah, we're just drinking. So the whole point is that we're like trying to make this idea of adventure seem accessible. We can do this. People can do this. It's absolutely viable. There's nothing about this that's like impossible.
Finding this campsite was an endeavor in and of itself. And we thought we were going to run out of gas. We found a gas station. The gas station had a sign that said, try your credit card, but it might not go through due to due to forest fires, internet, etc. Connectivity has been spotty. So like the only gas station where like gas light is on everything, and it might not even work. But fortunately, we got lucky, and the card went through. The, you know, the car started it every time. So there's that, which is already a win. Although there were a couple moments where it clicked for about 5 minutes.
Yes, there we go.
So that'll be an ongoing saga for us as well.
Are we getting water down there?
What's we were thinking?
I'll run out and dig it.
Actually, that'll go this way. Yeah. Like the looks of this way.
Billy and I want to go look.
Yeah.
You good?
Yeah, we should have filled up in the fucking sequel
thing. At any of the places.
At any of the places we've gone by.
I just don't know that.
Jump and rock.
Right. I just don't know what we're gonna have health-wise. And we're here right now. And there's a lake river thing.
All right. So basically, at the moment, what has occurred is that we were really smart and forgot to fill up all of our water before we left.
I didn't poop either.
And he didn't poop either. So now we're all really thirsty because we've run out of like the two bottles of water that we had. And rather than getting water where we could have gotten water like anywhere else that we've been, we waited until now.
I'm the one who's not gonna die because I'm not doing that. I'm just saying. This is really steep.
Greg made it. Billy made it.
So,
don't worry,
that was
guys.
Stupid. Day one.
Just to be out here in the wilderness, being able to enjoy this experience and look out the window of the car at these incredible landscapes that are passing me by, and trying to be a part of them whenever possible and escape.
People live together in society, in culture, because you can't do all this by yourself.
We built a fire tonight and cooked on hot rocks, and it was pretty awesome. You see why we've evolved from living in the wilderness, but you also really appreciate this is how
we
live for a long time, before civilization. And and that's fun, and that's exciting, and crazy, and I don't know. Today's been really crazy, in the best way possible.
It's been a long day. Long day. I'm nervous about a lot of things. I'm worried about the car. I mean, what was supposed to be a 4.5-hour drive today turned into a 9-hour drive today, and that can't continue. I mean, we can't make a 9-hour drive 18 hours. And we were relying on this thing to take us, you know, about 5,300 miles more than it's taken us already. So I'm definitely worried about it. It's a test, and so far so good.
So, this is me trying to start it in park. This is me trying to start it in drive, which is what the NSS does. It's a different click.
Yeah.
Yes.
Keep going, gas! Yes.
we want to get water. We kind of need it.
Do we want river or you want, because there's a river by Winthrop.
I mean, let's go for it.
Sexy.
That's the first time my hair's been wet in 4 or 5 days?
4 days.
What do we decide that was?
Camera that just fell off the car while we were doing 50 miles an hour, but let me tell you, it is working.
Be careful for splatter on these rocks. Oh my god, Billy,
you're doing good, staying in the same place.
Okay, so we have to figure out what we're doing today. Our intention initially was to camp right outside of the National.
If we pull into somewhere where we're gonna camp for the night in like 3-4 hours, then we can get a decent night's sleep get up early.
Yeah.
And it's on a lake.
Yeah.
So we'd be able to do dishes.
This better be comfortable. It's going there.
It's good. I got it.
Oh god! I just gave it to Andrew.
I gotta get you on a good camping area.
Exactly.
And you do not want to pay money,
right,
of course,
right.
So we don't go to campgrounds.
Right.
You'll see a V that goes towards a little store and a bar.
Right, yeah.
Take that left, maybe a third of a mile up, you'll take a right and it'll lead you right to Garfield Bay, and it's a really good camping spot.
Thank you
so much, guys. Put me and him in the documentary.
We're gonna camp on the fucking beach with like all these people and make a fire.
Okay, we gotta go fast though.
We just made hot water on the stove. We have a few sediments in there, but I've let it settle, so when we pour the coffee in, it's good to go. Slowly but surely, instant coffee. So peaceful. How are you feeling this morning?
I'm actually feeling good. I can't expect the same from Andrew or Billy. Especially not Andrew, he was a little
He was a little
loopy by the end of the night. I didn't expect parties on this trip. I didn't expect to get into a party. We found some friends in a campsite over there. So we went down there and ended up hanging out with them for a while, and it was, let's go with, a little completely insane. And also, I have no idea how old they were. And yes, I'm drinking coffee while holding an oven mitt.
This is where the party was last night. And Billy deciding he should go swimming.
Are you filming?
Oh yeah.
Now I look like a little bitch if I don't do it. I just want someone else to agree with me that it's a good idea.
I can't give you that.
I know, neither of you can. Doing the big jump.
Turn around! Turn around!
It hurts so much.
Turn around!
It's like a belly flop in 30
God damn it, turn around! Oh yeah.
What is that? Ow! There are so many little bumps.
I want to see that again. Yeah.
Montana, y'all.
Big Sky Country, y'all.
I can't see. Why do you keep saying that? Is that a turn?
Oh yeah.
That's the sky looks kind of the same as it did in Idaho.
That is the date motto.
Big or whatever. Are you sure it's not the slogan?
This is the stupidest motherfucking thing I've ever seen in my motherfucking life.
What is it?
What is it? Actual road work.
It's just Rhyme fucking stupid. And we're still going 20 goddamn miles an hour.
There's no explaining this. It's just Wait. Fucking stupid.
Oh, my head doesn't have traction in them.
Oh my god, I hate you.
It's too oily.
Oh my god, are we really fucking stopping again? Why are we fully stopped?
Alright, here we go.
Ow, god damn it! Ow! Fuck everything! Why is there a stop sign? Like, what the fuck? Can we just go? This is the stupidest thing.
It's not gonna change. Stop letting it affect your aim.
Well, it's just really annoying.
I know, but look where we are, man.
I fucking hate you guys.
I can see down.
I think we should have followed that regular road.
If you go back to the regular road, okay. That'll take us to like the lake, basically.
Let's do that.
To the lake. To the lake. To the lake. To the lake.
I dig this campsite.
We have store-bought fire starters, but
trying to avoid
I
using
like,
them. It's more fun to not use them.
Yeah. So the other place, our first night, I used moss that was on the ground. Here, you can use this like brittle, punky, like termite-infested, rotten wood. It just breaks in your hand and turns into dust.
Damn it! I didn't do it with one match this time.
Camera shy.
Camera shy, exactly. Performance anxiety. These guys are just going out instantly. It's just, sometimes you have to really nurse it along.
All right, I think it's past
danger point. Yeah, we're good.
Trying to find a nice level ground.
Okay, where's my tent?
If there's ever a day where we just want to get going in the morning, then I think it's tomorrow. Just go. God damn it. Billy quits right now.
I'm walking home.
I've been looking for my tent, and it was always right here.
Eric's struggling over here with the wind.
I'm pretty hungry, so I could eat a lot.
Billy, that stick is freaking...
Hey, y'all want to open up some tuna?
Yeah, where's the tuna at?
And try not to spill any tuna juice. So much for not losing
didn't
the tuna
spill,
juice.
Didn't spill because it didn't open over. Didn't open. Sometimes,
thankfully, guys... Greg is so bad at his job, he didn't actually pierce it.
No.
My own little fire. You know, it's assholes like me that create all these wildfires.
So, here we go for three. One, two, three!
It's day four. Five? Four. I like waking up in this peacefulness. We saw one car drive by last night. One, literally. And there's a bee on me, as you can see. Yeah, this is amazing. Is everything shut? The trunk is shut.
Trunk is shut.
Everything's tied. Okay. Look at me in this seat. Off we go. No blue jacket or blue pillow can conquer me.
You say that, but I'm pretty sure I got hit with a blue pillow while driving.
So. How you doing? Do you need more?
Fucking pillow.
The sky is losing snow.
So really the next thing we're doing though is turning on to go into the sunroof.
God, I love this.
The white flakes scattered across the sky look like polka dots in the twilight.
Ah, this is it.
Your frozen fingers have gripped my tight, and I am happy to be by your side.
Always
gonna
be people here.
Why is that car stopped?
No, but why is this car stopped?
I'd slow down, yeah.
Now they can out their spot can't be entirely possible. Oh, hey bud, what's up?
Is it a kitty?
Nope, not even close to a kitty.
It's big totally to be, a groundhog.
Too big to be a groundhog.
Dude, I'm right.
God, he's adorable. What is he?
The front half is prairie dog and the back half is like
raccoon.
So strange, like he knows us.
Yes!
He got
it. Yes! Yes!
Direct! You need clip box.
I know.
The breakfast and lunch of, and snack of champions.
Dinner.
And dinner. No. God, I want some more mac and cheese.
How about that?
I love it.
Did you get all of that?
I got all of it.
Okay, and you met this crazy guy from Texas.
Texas,
Texas.
And if I could have brought it on the plane, I would have also been packing my 357.
Nice.
Which I carry in case I encounter something vicious with no legs or two legs or four legs. Or,
absolutely.
Totally.
And you never can tell what you'll find on a mountain trail.
You're absolutely right.
That's why we're doing it. We're traveling all the way through the country, starting in Seattle, going back to New York.
Oh, that's very cool.
Hitting all the national parks.
We're doing it for less than $150 a week.
What are you driving in?
A 1984 Subaru GL all-wheel drive.
murky eyes and ruffled lips. Your face is a page, but I'm reading it like a brick. Drunken words and twisted wires.
I feel like Lawrence of Arabia right now, to be honest.
There's construction on the upper part of the Going to the Sun Road, and so it slowed us getting up here, and now we're trying to find our camp spot, and we're sitting in a line. The guy said it's about 10 minutes. We'll see.
Well, I just don't. Do you like being here right now? Because we have no idea where we are.
Do we want to turn, guys?
So just,
this is not where we were yet.
I'm turning.
I just mean, like, what point did it change?
I don't know.
So for the third consecutive night, we don't fucking know where we're going.
Yeah. Well, why didn't you say that? Because I saw that and thought there's no way we could possibly go in that way. It's much smaller. You were the navigator.
I wasn't navigating.
Well, that's obvious. This doesn't look like a fucking road.
It is.
Watch out for that rock!
I do see that rock. This is not a road.
Oh, it's not a road.
Fucking moron.
Guys, we're home!
Hyom?
We're
home! We're
Hyom!
What the fuck is Hyom?
You got a lot of it.
Guys, we have nothing to do with this.
I know, it's great. So already, this is bypassing the expectations that I have.
Yeah, I mean, the fact that we're staying in a place like this.
I can't.
We don't have to pay for it.
I'm just trying to talk realistically about this so far. You guys are arguing a lot.
Yes, we are.
And you know it.
Yes, you're not wrong.
And we know it.
Yep, you're not wrong.
We all need to look at our faults and be able to take criticism.
My thing is, it's okay if we do fuck up. We're not only doing this.
We're doing a lot.
Which I've never done before. Yeah. Ever. I've camped a few times, but not like
this. I've camped a lot, but this is different.
And not only are we doing that, we're trying to film that happen.
Yeah.
Thank you, Andrew. Thank you.
Oh. Team effort for the mac and cheese. We are in Montana, bear country, and when you camp, you need to do a bear bag.
Because we got lots of food that smells really yummy. So we're gonna throw the rock up over, if you can see where I'm pointing, over that limb. And that should be good enough for a bear not to get to our food. Can he do it the first time? He did it the first time! That was amazing.
You gotta teach me these. Bears would attack if Billy wasn't here.
There are three wraparounds, and then a down, and then another wraparound, and then a down wraparound.
Absolutely layman's terms.
Layman's terms.
Okay.
All right. Don't fall, Billy.
So go ahead and start pulling.
All right, ready? One, two. Yes! Check it out. Look at that. Look at that. Two ropes, carabiner, and a backpack. That's all you need.
And that's us bear bagging.
Good work. Bear bag team, USA.
There's this wire right here that I'm disconnecting. This is because our car sometimes doesn't start. So I have to disconnect it and then bridge a gap between the hot wire.
So you're basically hot wiring the car, Greg.
Yes.
Don't lie to us.
And there it goes. It's on now. Check it out.
No key turn necessary. I didn't turn the key. He just turned it on from there.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you hot wire a car.
I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts, bare man. I breathe the mountain air, man. Of travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere.
That's cool.
That's really cool.
Where the deer and the antelope play.
I've never seen an antelope live in America before.
Is that right?
So glad I had my camera ready.
That was awesome. And there they go.
Oh, man. Holy crap.
Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word,
and the skies are not cloudy all day.
You said you had the best directions for this place, and so that's why we went with it.
All right, do you want to go that way?
Yes.
All right.
Let's go that way.
All right, so turn around.
It's the one that burnt down?
Part of it did.
Amazing. Greg, it was the store that burnt down. That's our landmark.
130 extra miles.
About that.
It'd be interesting how many miles we added because we had to find our place. Alright, here it is.
Yeah.
This is our landmark.
Jack!
What the fuck?
Boot Jack.
Right?
Holy fucking shit.
Are you kidding me?
Wait.
Holy fucking shit.
What are the fucking odds of that?
This is awesome.
The fuck?
Serendipity.
I don't know if serendipity or just blind luck.
Can't be both.
Home on.
They're happy.
The where
they wait for us. Let's get stuff out and then send someone for water.
So we found our campsite.
Yes, we did.
Yes, we did.
But unfortunately, there's no water to be had.
Andrew and I washed dishes and pumped water at a river like 2 miles down today. I just think it's hilarious. I mean, it's funny. We drive into our camp. We set it up, and then we have to say, okay, well, where we have to clean dishes, we need fresh water, and we need to purify our water. So, where do we go? Yeah, you know, it's not readily accessible, especially at some of these free campsites.
What I think is amazing about this is look at how brown that water is, especially because a couple guys walked through here a little bit ago, kicked up all the dirt. Look at that.
Clean.
Crystal clean.
We're making something awesome. We got rice, of course, because it's kind of become our staple. And then rice with beans, corn, chicken, and some potatoes.
I think we get stressed because we're so used to just finding our way and knowing exactly the quickest path, but there's something special about getting lost and having the opportunity to talk to someone to find out where you are instead of resorting to technology to figure it out for you.
We woke up to cows mooing.
Oh, yeah, I heard it.
Murr.
I got really excited when I heard that.
And I heard their cowbells too.
They are all really wet. It's true.
So I was hoping that a cow would walk into our campsite. That's better than a bear.
I'm getting shit for my hoodie.
Because it's 45 degrees and you didn't pack correctly.
No, right, we all just stand in a row really quick and see if the viewers at home can point out one of these things is not like the other.
Yeah, one of them has a walking stick. I have layers.
That'll keep you really warm.
I have layers. Layers are fine.
Fun news on my end is that the other day when we were rope swinging, I like rope swung into a bush, right? No big deal. Not a big deal.
Cut footage to him swinging into a bush.
Yeah, we can do that.
No!
But then I got these bug bites and I thought that's all it was. But now, I mean, I don't really, you know, need to drop trowel for you, but up here there's a big ol'
I think you
itchy
do.
Rash. And on my foot, there's an itchy rash where I was scratching things and like that. So I think I've got I don't know if it's poison ivy or in that
poison
family.
Poison sumac.
Or something else,
I don't know,
but.
Man. Poison oak. Hepatitis.
The two Redlawsk brothers lose because they're both itchy and cold.
I'm not itchy, I'm just cold.
We're thinking, because we lost a day, we're thinking about trying to make that day up by going further today.
and potentially we haven't decided exactly how far we want to go.
I do think that we can make this to here in one day. I don't think that's impossible. I actually think that's quite doable.
How many miles?
I'm not sure because I need to flip over to Wyoming to see how much this is.
We're only going 207 miles in Wyoming, which isn't that much. That's less than a trip to Chicago from Iowa City.
We'll see.
No, so 207 miles in Wyoming would add up to probably be about 300 miles overall.
Yeah.
But that's doable.
That's way less than yesterday.
We did like 450 yesterday. So 300's absolutely doable. I think it's a good plan.
What are we doing?
We're going to go ahead and try to make it all the way down to Utah tonight. See if we can make it. Northern Utah, the Cache National Forest. Should be fun.
Ba-da-da-da-da.
La, 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 la. It was a good time to stop and watch the city breathe. Though, you know, now we're lost.
Thank you.
Have nothing to lose. I remember simple things. How's a building get so tall? No one way to explain, since we have not yet seen all the good times.
That's a buffalo poop.
Good times, oh, the good times. Shouldn't be this hard to find.
Well, I'm unimpressed. Is it hard?
It's a little underwhelming, to be honest.
This is what everyone comes.
I would have expected more.
Meh. Alright, let's go.
When I see the people standing there, shy, cerebral, and the lonely hair, disenchanted, stony eyes.
I say as he's snuggling in the spot, he's kind of rocking back.
For the
moment,
they'll come alive intimate. But still strangers, the dangers in each other's eyes.
Sorry, people behind me. We are going up, 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 and this car has 73 horsepower.
We're doing it, man. Garden City?
Yeah, so we're in Garden City, and there's like lines of people outside of all the places.
So why are there so many lines all the places? Is that like just a thing every day?
Shake time.
Shake time, right, no, that's what it seems like. So
is this town just Shake Town?
Well, it's known for like raspberries.
Okay, so that's why they're raspberry shake places. Yeah. All over the place.
Yeah. Is this the best shake in town?
Everyone's from like nearby.
Yeah.
Merlin's. There wasn't a line outside, but there definitely is a line inside.
Yeah, this is probably the best.
Alright, this is the best.
1 pound hamburger.
Is that the Merlinator?
Yeah, the Merlinator.
And you get your picture on it.
His picture's on it.
If you eat it, I know.
You get your picture taken. Then you throw up.
This is going to be a disaster.
Look at that. Can it be done?
3, 2, 1, go.
Going.
I give up.
I think if there was no cheese, I could do it. And Billy's done.
No sauce.
What's the time, Billy? What's the time?
Do you have sauce?
5:49. 5:49.
5:49. I didn't make the record.
But still,
but I did it under
good.
10 minutes.
Yeah. Billy had no sauce on his. To be fair,
kind of cheating. I don't think it's cheating.
You had a burger already.
I have as much left.
Digestive systems.
This is the worst idea
ever.
I'm almost done.
I'm watching you. Right, Eric, let's see it. Oh, he did a home run play.
The bathroom is right there.
It doesn't count until you swallow.
1258.
Yeah!
Mine was upside down.
Alright, we'll let the door close.
And because we were so fat, we could not start the car.
Did it!
Sometimes you gotta start a car with a pair of pliers.
Pair of pliers?
Yep.
I did.
You just did that? Yeah. Hey, good job!
Well, I wouldn't start.
He's
with
pretty
me.
Impressive.
Where are you guys visiting from?
Well, license plate.
I'm from New York, I'm from Chicago.
No way?
Yeah.
Sweet. Where are you guys from in New York?
Manhattan.
No way?
Yeah.
I'm so jealous. I don't live there.
It's a lot of fun. Are you guys from here?
I'm from Sun Valley, Idaho.
We're actually making a documentary of traveling from Seattle to New York, going 100 miles across like all like not mostly not main highways, things like that, going
that's
all like, different
sweet.
States. And
that's
doing,
so cool.
And we're doing it all on like a limited budget.
So let's go.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, nice
you.
Meeting you.
Nice to meet you.
See you later.
Thanks.
On and on until we know nothing now is ours to keep as we taste the salt, the sea.
Rub it in more poison ivy.
I need some way to keep the rash itself from rubbing against my shoes and against my pants and the shorts and everything. So far this seems to work kind of well. You know, fingers crossed, because it hasn't been very pleasant so far.
Wish it was not fucking raining. It's...
Do you have any clue what it could be?
No. I'm disconnecting the battery, giving it a moment. Just gonna disconnect it and then kind of see if there's any corrosion or anything like that. That would be causing it. I don't see any.
I tied this cord so the water won't slide anymore.
You fixed your problem.
I fixed my problem.
It was raining, the hood's open, the battery.
is being very weird. So when he revs up the engine, the voltage goes up, which isn't normal. But on the bright side, Billy fixed the water cooler.
Dead in the water.
I mean, here's the thing. We can get anywhere going fucking slow.
Yeah, we can.
So
we'll probably have to do that.
We should do that.
Thought that might help.
Does it?
It does.
So if we use more electricity, it'll work better.
That was what I was thinking. So I'm not changing speed at all and it's going up. But it turns the lights on and it immediately drops.
Drops back down.
That was the most hilarious shot of electricity.
I don't know exactly what our campsite looks like tonight, but I do know that it's on a plateau, which means it might be super windy, but it might also be super awesome. So, here's hoping.
Such an awesome thing we're doing.
Wetness! I haven't showered in days.
Oh, we haven't been able to take a shower, take a bath, have a lake that would be able to, you know, clean ourselves in for like days and days, not since Idaho, like day two or day three. And it's day eight.
Woke us up. Andrew threw up. Billy slept through it all.
So not only am I covered in massive itchy rashes that are agonizingly painful when I wear clothes and move, y'all are sick of hearing me say that, but last night I decided that maybe it'd be fun to get a little dehydrated and nauseous on top of it. So that's where I'm at this morning.
Now he's a pee.
So we were just in the visitor center. Wiped. We were exhausted, tired, hungry, thirsty. And we were just sitting there looking at a map like, where do we want to go? There's a freaking apple orchard. Free to eat. Do you hear that? Free.
It's just a you pick, like honor system type of place. And it's $1.25 per pound.
But it's free.
To just eat while we're in there.
Sample.
It's a sample. Andrew, look what I found immediately.
I've never picked an apple off a tree in my life.
No, I have no idea if they're right.
Like to eat. Damn it.
Apples and bananas.
I like to eat.
Oh yeah. Eat. That's a fucking apples and
bananas. This is the greatest find ever, along with our find of raspberry land and
oh my god, this is like perfect. Just like this moment.
We are in an oasis of apples.
I mean, look at either side of us. Desert scrub, giant walls.
Maybe we should just camp here tonight.
We've had a couple days, actually. Surprisingly enough, a really, really good couple of days. Today might be tricky. We're going to Moab, doing White Rim Road, and it's definitely going to be a challenge.
Where there's actual like risk involved.
There's serious risk.
Well, not
here.
Just that, but like risky, you know, there's stuff. In this whole area, like we're talking like a 40-mile radius. There's no food, water, gasoline, anything. Like there's nothing.
Oh my God, we have no gas.
There's nothing.
Good thing we have an empty tank.
Well, yeah, because it just dehydrates you.
I just want to get off the throat.
The canteen down at your feet.
You want water?
Yeah.
Great. That's it.
Thanks, man.
Rickards, what can we do?
I think I just need to go.
Okay, why don't we do this?
That's not good. Take another dehydration break. It's good though.
What are you most looking forward to in Denver?
Getting completely clean, including being able to finally like wash my whole body, including my poison ivy.
I'm looking most forward to showering. my hair.
So greasy.
Although I feel cleaner than I did yesterday. Explain that to me. I haven't showered in, what, how many days, Andrew? Six, seven, nine, 20.
Ready, Billy.
We need to get like a contagious sign for your tent.
Yeah, right? Stay out.
Stay out.
Beware of illness. Oh, that's good. Sing a song, Andrew. I'll play along to you.
That's okay.
What do you mean? You're by a campfire in the middle of nowhere.
All right, so today is Denver Day, which means we're making the push to Denver, which also means showers, which is incredibly, incredibly exciting. The poison ivy thing has been getting crazy. I haven't been able to wash myself properly since getting it, so I haven't been able to 100% eradicate the oils that it leaves on your skin, and that's how it gets spread. So I figured one of the best ways, since we're right next to this river here, and it's a really great, like the mud is really soft, it's this red clay, and so I decided to put it on my poison ivy areas and let it dry. It helps sort of leach out the ooziness of the poison ivy, because it dries to your skin, and drying it out is what will help it to go away faster. It just feels good. So I'm just letting this dry off, and I'll look like a mess when I get to Denver. It'll be ridiculous, but it'll be absolutely worth it.
Greg, did you feel better after you threw up?
Yeah, a little bit. Then I threw up again.
So we got this mystery bug going around the car. It hit Andrew, and then it hit Greg, and now it's hitting Eric.
That was weird. Over. Yeah, it's weird, because when I got it, I felt really convinced it was dehydration, because I've been dehydrated before. I've had that experience before, and I felt identical. Greg took a longer time to bounce back, and then I don't know, I mean, we'll see how things go there.
What's going on, Eric?
Well, now I feel better.
That's always how it works.
Good thing you didn't have any of that chocolate. What a wasted chocolate.
Okay, so that's the third one. So it was me first, Greg yesterday, and now Eric today.
And then there was one.
Clearly Billy is next. Although he's invincible, so it's possible it might avoid him.
I'm thinking maybe it has something to do with the food we're eating, maybe, or the clean dishes. And I would just like to thank my mother for cooking so poorly my entire life that she's kind of trained my stomach to take this kind of food and this cooking, this subpar cooking. So thank you, Mother.
I mean, once we rinse, it's still usually in a rinser.
We have been washing dishes with river water.
You are very right about that.
Now, you guys got it in my head. I'm freaking out that I'm going to get sick now, so I'm like, I want to at least eat something.
That's true.
He was born in the summer of his 27th year, coming home to a place he'd never been before. He left yesterday behind him. You might say he was born again. You might say he found the key for every door. When he first came to the mountains, his life was far away. On the road and hanging by a song. But the string's already broken and he doesn't really care. It keeps changing fast and it don't last for long. If the Colorado Rocky Mountain High, I've seen it rain and fire.
This is an absolutely astoundingly amazing road. I like can't even get over it. And we're up around 12,000 feet right now, which is just unbelievably ridiculous. Yeah, I said this before, I keep having new favorites. And right now, this is my favorite.
It's cold up here.
It's very cold up here. It feels like it's like 30, 40 degrees out.
And they say that he got crazy once, and he tried to touch the sun. And he lost a friend, but kept a memory. Now he walks in quiet solitude, inside has turned inside himself to try and understand.
So we have one windshield wiper that's working, and one that is
trying.
It's trying its best, but it's not particularly successful.
It works now.
Oh, look, there it goes. So this is Andrew.
Hey,
Andrew,
I know you.
And this is Eric.
Eric!
Everyone's
on camera!
Good to meet you.
You got a real bed, Andrew.
Look at my bed. Look at it. It's so comfy.
With your foot.
It's like backwards Roman body armor.
I'm happy with sleeping on the floor because it's actually a floor and not rocks. It's gonna be great.
This is mine.
We have this pretty amazing morning right now, where we actually woke up not in a campsite. Here we have bacon being made by Sophie, which is just unbelievable.
Yeah. Boiled bacon.
We're gonna try and rig up the car and maybe get it in a little bit better, more functional shape. Right now we've just been kind of...
What's wrong with the car?
Oh, there's nothing wrong with the car. It's just that...
Well, there's plenty wrong with the car.
Okay, yes, I'll rephrase. There are plenty of things wrong with the car. But right now our major issue is that like things are a little disorganized, it's a little crazy back there, there's a lot of stuff and not a lot of space. So one of the things we're going to try to do today is just rig it up to maybe like create some pouches, some pockets, just make the car more livable, more usable for the next 10 days, next 12 days, next however long it takes us to get back to New York from here.
Billy threw up.
Oh my god, it's ridiculous.
And that's literally the face I wanted.
One you after the other after the other after the
other. Everybody looks like...
Billy, what happened?
Yeah, he's...
I threw up a bunch.
Yesterday, Eric was really pale.
Are you feeling any better right now?
I am feeling so much better.
Driving cross-country. We're going from Seattle to New York on basically... spending less per person per week than the average American spends on food.
Okay.
And so the whole point is that we're like trying to make this idea of adventure seem accessible. It's been good and it's been fun. And it's like, you know, when we started out, we were like, we think we can do this. And after having done it for like, this is our 11th day of the trip, I'm like, we can do this. People can do this.
In my dirty pickup truck, rescue my postmodern damsel in distress.
Our gut is that the alternator died. Because about an hour ago, the volts went from like 10 to none. After they had been super high for days. And then as of this morning, they were super low. And now they're gone.
To call AAA at some point here.
That one looks abandoned.
It does look abandoned.
Going to that fucking abandoned gas station. Let's just go hang out there and then call AAA. It's the only thing we can do. Push the car, guys.
So, here we are in a hotel room. We broke down on the side of the interstate. We managed to
jump it three times to get it to get to an exit. We jumped it four times to get it enough charge to drive like a mile to a mile and a half. Till the point we could get it off the interstate.
Then we
pushed it into an abandoned gas station. We hope that we can get it fixed tomorrow and be back on the road. Either way, we're stuck here in Trinidad, Colorado for the night.
In a hotel room,
which,
because unfortunately we can't camp out.
So it's a big drain on our budget, but we still think we can make it.
On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been. Seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again. Road again, like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way, and our way. On the road again, I just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again.
What's the issue?
The transmission's fucking broken.
So we probably shouldn't drive long distances.
Not necessarily, we don't know that.
Yeah, it's not accelerating normally.
We have had a little bit of a catastrophe, and so now the car won't go in reverse. Basically, it neutrals in reverse. In neutral, it'll drive forward. In park, it'll be parked. And in drive, it goes up to third gear.
So we're definitely really low on transmission fluid. We don't have a third gear. Fuck! Yeah, it's broken. Listen, I cannot hear it. Fuck! It's not over. The car's, and my engine's, everything's dying.
Yeah, it's done. We need to find an actual mechanic right now.
So we've got like an old 84 Subaru four-wheel drive. Didn't drive really great, it's got low miles on it. But then we realized suddenly our reverse wasn't working properly. So we feel like what we were thinking is it might have slipped something in there.
Like he said, it's if you just shift it like we've been doing, then it'll get us where we're going.
But so let's just go.
Let's just go. I mean, that's what he said, too. And, you know, mechanics will want to sell you stuff if they, you know, like...
I hear you.
If a mechanic is telling you not to get it fixed.
Oh, my God.
Stupid fucking thing I've ever seen.
I love this car. It's terrible, and it's a piece of shit.
Well, it's a piece
it's
of shit,
piece of shit. But it can four-wheel drive like nobody's business.
Welcome to Nashville. Welcome to Nashville.
We're in Nashville, Tennessee. We're staying at Greg's friend's place, which is so nice. They have a house, and I get this room, which is sweet. I get a futon. We had a little freak out today with the car. It's interesting. We have conquered our fears, and we are doing this trip, and we're setting out on this adventure, and that in and of itself is a challenging thing. What I find really fascinating about this trip is that things are thrown in your path, in your way, as you make a choice. We made the choice to do this adventure, and then things come along the way and test us. The choice to rise above that and choose the path that is not giving in to base emotions.
Basically, in light of yesterday's transmission extravaganza, we had to figure out a lot of things.
My vote is to minimize extraneous mileage.
I would still like to spend a full day in Chattanooga,
mm-hmm.
Because there's a lot to do there, mm-hmm. in ways of outdoors and river activities. May your day be merry and bright, and may all your
Christmases be white. Well, you know, this motor oil, you need it, you know, to get into all the wheels and the gears and the windshield wipers.
Definitely, so the windshield. Definitely.
We need to add it to, you know, get the air conditioning working and stuff.
It's not gonna.
It's hard to run the air conditioning without the motor oil. Most mechanics will tell you otherwise, that it's something completely unrelated to what I just said. But a little known fact, that's not true. It's all about the motor oil.
By the river when the sun's going down, make a little fire, pass a bottle round. I need no pants, so follow on the sound. Oh, I see you down there. You can tell the teeth are red, just licking their thighs. We'll all be here when Jack and Jim arrive, and it'll be just us in the trees in a little
bit.
We just met these Italian guys.
They were incredible.
Incredible.
And
they played
bluegrass.
From Italy.
From Italy.
You guys have hard times in this journey of making your documentary?
Yes.
Have you gone
been helped through those times?
What's that?
You've been helped through those times by people
we have.
You didn't know.
We have.
That's the
we
moral
have.
Of the story. Be a good person. Help people.
Part of me can't wait to be done with this trip. Part of me can't believe we're near the end, and part of me is going to be really sad to see it go, because it's been so nice and so weirdly freeing. But at the same time, I can't help but be preoccupied with what's going on back home, what's happening, what should I be working on. But I don't have to. I can still just enjoy a few more days of this trip.
Fire pit right there, the lake, beautiful lush grass to sleep on.
It's our last day of camping. Crazy. I don't even know what day it is anymore. But we're almost done. And mission Beard, successful. Tennessee was great. We spent so much time on the river, and something about water that I just love, and I love being a part of that.
Well, last night. Okay. Well, last night, camping.
Yeah.
the governor.
To the governor.
To the governor. Okay, we're done.
Get him eventually. Coals are the hottest part of the fire.
You're a coal.
Damn. I think for a couple days I had a little poison ivy in my butt.
The last morning at a campsite, how do you feel?
I got a mouthful of oatmeal.
Mouthful of oatmeal?
Mouthful of oatmeal. Could be a band. It's a bit strange for it to be the last time we camp in the morning. But today is to DC. In truth, I will be a little disappointed, but sad, because I've been enjoying the camping. It's kind of nice to never wake up at 7 a.m. anywhere else. And to be fair, we don't usually wake up at 7 a.m. while camping either.
I found my compass. So now we'll be able to know which way we're going.
The funniest thing for me, I don't know about all of this, is it gets me to the point of I do want to keep going out and seeing more of the country and seeing more of people around, because this trip, for all of the troubles and trials and tribulations, has resulted in me thinking, man, a lot of people are better than I thought they were. It's really easy to be super cynical about people, but this trip has been sort of a verification of the opposite.
This window wiper work so that the driver can see. And it's.
Don't be a hero. We trust each other to give us signals when we're feeling down. This is what the journey was about, and it was about going out on a limb. It was about having an adventure, and you really do need.
And I can't believe it's over. Part of me is excited. I think we're all excited tonight in the car to be coming back to New York, but it's funny when something's ending, you suddenly don't want it to end. I'm like out of things to say other than that. I'm just blown away that we've done it all. We're here. 50 miles from New York City.
And that's a freeze frame.
It's that old saying that when you're home, you dream of being away. When you're away, you dream of being home. So here's to the unknown. Cheers.